love when we are two different persons that are not meant to be compatible, but love is meant to be. If I love you because we are compatible, it's not still love. But if my love can make the difference in your life, you are not qualified to be close to me, but my love magnetizes you. What relationship has a lamb got to do with a wolf? So if the wolf and the lamb can stay together, that is the ideal kind of love that God is talking about. Many times in the church have we chased the allot away. We are looking for perfect people. We cannot get perfect generation. The church is a spiritual depot where prostitutes can come and be transformed to children of light. The church is a place where thieves and armed robbers can come and be transformed from being armed robbers to godly children. The church is a place where 419 can come and be transformed. It is not a place for perfect people. It is a place to turn the imperfect to perfect. You, if you have what it takes to lead, lead. He said a child will lead them. The army of a lion, a leopard, the army of a sheep, a child will lead them. Why will the child lead them? The child will lead them because of the heart of the child. If you check children, whenever they have misunderstanding, they forgive. Jesus said to the disciple, he said, except you become like this little one, I can tell you why God is raising men like Joshua Aguilar and others. It is because we do not look qualified in your eyes, but we have the love of a child, the heart of a child. You can see us as a baby, but what we have is our heart. And I can tell you, God is not after the charisma, the capacity, and the competency of a man. He's looking for a love generation. People with the heart of love. Men that will give and not look back. Men that will love and not look back. Men that will release and not look back. A generation that have the fear of God. A generation that will not backstab their father. What is going on? Where people are raised up by their father, and at the tail end, they go behind to backstab their father. What is going on? When pastors pay one another to kill one another, this is not the love generation. He said, my father, make them one, just as you and I are one. But the body of Christ are not one. I'm not preaching church here. I'm not preaching division here. I'm preaching one thing, the message of Christ, and that's the message of love. A father over the president of this country, the Lord over his household, and the ruler in Egypt. Joseph begin to tell them, this kind of love is called the forgiving love. People backstab you. People betray you. They frustrated you. It is called the kind of love you give to your family members for offending you. Who am I? charge him not at Gath. Tell him not at Ashkelon. That our heroes, he still immortalized Saul. Despite the fact Saul had backslided. Once anointed, forever anointed. Once anointed, forever anointed. Who are you to deal with a man of God based on the mistake of the man of God, when the God who called the man of God cannot despise the man of God? Was David anointed? Yes, David was anointed. But what was the anointing of David? The anointing of David came after Saul. So in anointing, there is hierarchy. And that's why, no matter how anointed you are, durability is the counting anointing section. We've talked about types of love. We've talked about staunch. We said it's the experience, it's the kind of love we experience in our family, which is S-T-O-R-G-E, staunch. And we talk about the next kind of love, and these are Greek words, philo. And philo is experienced among friends, this kind of love that friends express to one another. And we talk about the third kind of love, eros. And we said this is an erotic kind of love. This has to do with sexual expression. Most often, this kind of love is a worldly love and is built on infatuation. And what is infatuation? This is love at first sight that each time it's put to test, it dies overnight. Somebody says, I love you, I can't do without you. Give that person just 3 months, or he sees your weakness or see your perfection, or he get close to you. At once, that love dies, because it cannot stand the test of time. It's called infatuation. It fluctuates, getting from fluctuation. So you will understand. It's a love that fluctuates, cannot be steady, cannot stand the test of time. So I've talked about staunch, I've talked about filial, I've talked about eros love, and the last love is the kind of love which is called the agape kind of love, and that is God's kind of love. God's kind of love. And I pray for you that you will enter this kind of love. Must not love you because we do the same thing. That is the problem with the body of Christ. You hear this pastor said, I don't believe in deliverance, and so we cannot be friends. That's not the scripture. If the problem comes, if the cow can have a relationship with the lion, if the lamb can have a relationship off. That love itself is not until when we are agreed on philosophy and principles. I've seen people say, I don't like using miracle word. And so what? It doesn't change. Is it what that means? You just choose not to practice it, and I choose to practice it. We have allowed doctrinal issues to cause division. We have allowed our professions to cause division. We have allowed our tribe to cause division. We have allowed looking and seeking for perfect and excellent people to cause division. That most often, the people that God rises up for us to love.